Okay, let's see some of the wonderful things that we can do with text combined with the brushes tool. I've got some text here, and this is proper text that I've just typed. This is in Arial Black, and the first thing I'm going to do is change the type to outlines. See, type, create outlines there. I think it'll just be a bit nicer to look at. And I'm just going to swap the colours. So at the moment the text has got this white fill and black stroke. Okay, right, let's just apply some brushes. I found these brushes here called Artistic Ink, and just in case you're wondering, you know, where they came from, if you look in your normal brushes palette here, there's a brushes palette. From there, if you select this little thing here and open brush library, there's a selection of more brushes. Okay, so for instance, I'm going to Artistic here, and I've got Artistic Ink, which I've got open at the moment, and Artistic Paintbrush. So there's the Artistic Paintbrushes come up there, as you can see. And also in the tab there is the other one. So I can switch between the two. So, you know, there are a lot more brush styles than you can actually see in your default Illustrator palette there. Okay, so let's just try applying something then. Here we go. Just click on there. And there's a very interesting thing. It looks like, you know, brush text. It looks like something that's been done in Photoshop rather than Illustrator, but it's still vector. That's the main point about all this. If you think, you know, that the brush stroke is a bit thick, you can actually just change it from here. That makes that like that. Okay, I'll tell you what, I'll copy this down a few times. I'll hold the Alt key and we'll have a few different versions of this text. So I'll do that. Okay, so on this one, we'll try this one here, see how that looks. There you go, different effect again. And this one, I'll try this silly looking thing here, just see what that does. Oops, not too good that, but you know, it is a rather strange looking object, but I think if we change the thickness, it might be a bit better. No, it still looks a bit weird, don't like that. I'll try this one here, and that's just a straightforward sort of brush effect, but because I changed it to 0.25 there, I'll just put it back to 1, and I think, yeah, now you see that looks interesting. And finally we'll just try some of these here. There we go, marker smooth, this says. Okay, and maybe even make that a little bit bigger, thicker, and see how that looks. So we've got various different styles there of text. Of course you can still use the fill, give them a fill, and everything looks very nice and hunky-dory. And the whole point of this is it doesn't look like vector, because one of the criticisms, if you like, of vector programs is that, you know, text and images sometimes look a little bit too computerized, too smooth, whereas you might want a more painterly effect like that. So that's a good reason for using the brush tool to outline text. Very nice. Now I've just applied this this one here, Dry Brush 5. I've just applied that to this text here. Oh, and by the way, when you apply any brush, it doesn't have to be black, of course, if you just select it, just like any other object, it's got a stroke colour. So if you want a different colour for the stroke, that's fine. I rather like the black, so I'll go back to black for the moment. Now then, This is very interesting. You see this wonderful text. Supposing you thought, well, yeah, I like that, but maybe this C here is perhaps it's a bit too thick. I wish I could just thin it down a little bit. Well, let's see. If you click on it, if you go to view an outline, you may be surprised to see that, you know, that you can't actually see the stroke, the special brush stroke. That's because it doesn't really exist yet. However, we can make it exist so that we can, you know, edit it, perhaps with the white arrow. At the moment, that's impossible. We can edit the shape of the actual letters, but we can't edit this brush effect that's around it at the moment. So let's just go back to normal preview for a minute. Okay, so what we're now going to do is Object, Expand Appearance. Right, now let's go to the view menu now, and right away you can see there that, you know, there is editable areas, editable points here. I can get my white arrow, for instance. I can click on this and I can move some of these little handles or points or whatever you want to call them. Doesn't matter what you call them, the point is you can move them. Okay, and if you want to extend something, you know, any part of something, I'll just do this. It won't particularly look good, but it's just to show you what it looks like. Okay, so I'm extending some of those little points there, and if we now go to preview, you can see clearly that what we've done, we've extended the points as I've done there. You can do that in the preview or in the outline, it doesn't matter, but this is completely editable. Okay, so that's pretty wonderful. That should keep you occupied for hours playing with that. Lovely.